What's going on, guys? My name is Dimitri and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to work with a little job application tracker in Notion. It's something that I used for my own personal use when applying to jobs and internships throughout college. And while I have a job I like now, I just still want to show people who don't have jobs they like or want to find a new job a way to track that in Notion and kind of organize their life in a way that might be better than what they're currently doing.
But this is the application tracker that I actually used personally in order to get myself to get a job. So I don't actually have the listing for the job that I ended up working with, but these are a bunch of old ones. And since they were pretty old, I figured it'd be okay to use these. And the basic things you have here are you can have at the top your resume, your cover letter template, and a portfolio if you have one. And then there's the database here right below it. And that has all the applications and kind of has the different stages of where you're at in the process. And then below that, you can have a working draft of your resume. And this is an example one, like a lorem ipsum sort of setup here. Now, mine does not look like this. Obviously, I'm not going to show my resume. But the whole point of this here is we can have a working draft of our resume, and actually we can have a working draft of our cover letter template as well. And by having our working draft of resume and cover letter on this page, what we can do is we can easily kind of look at the different posting URLs and things that come up in our job applications and edit that to tweak and maybe possibly make a duplication of this, paste this into a Word document, and then quickly and easily adjust what we have on our resume and cover letter to kind of fit the job posting, as that's kind of the way to go when you're wanting to look at jobs. You don't wanna have it be just the same thing for everyone. You wanna customize a little bit when you're applying so that you can have your skills fit the need of the job. And if you have a lot of different experience, it might be the route to go if you wanna like change the kind of route you're going with in your career path. If you have some prior experience that is a little bit more applicable, or if you have different skills and specific hard skills that you want to point out for a different kind of job, say a marketing job versus an operations job, those are going to have much different hard skills that they're looking for and maybe some different experience as well. So for the application database, the properties, as you can see here, there are a bunch of different ones. There's obviously the position name. I basically have it as the name is like the company, and the position name is here. Whether it's a job or an internship, it could be kind of both. And the reason it'd be both is if it's an internship that then turns into a job. So this is the order of things that we have here. We have interested, ready to apply, followed up, applied, referred, message recruiter. And then after that, we would have what ends up happening, which is offered, signed, nothing available, or rejected. Now moving forward with this, we can have the location type be filtered as well in this database, whether it's in-person, remote, hybrid, or otherwise. Then we have the due date, which sometimes happen, sometimes isn't needed. And then we have where is the work location? What is the recruiter's email if we can get it? What is the posting URL? And then we can attach the resume we would use for this. As we talked about earlier, there can be a customized resume for the application. Same with the cover letter. And then we can put any notes that we want here. So moving forward, I do want to show you guys a template that I have for a new role. So if we go into the new role, the application documents would be here. I have attached what was my own most recent form of my resume, but you don't have to have that. You can remove that and then go into the application documents, action items, notes on the company. Where can you add value? Where can you be excited about? What are you excited about? What will you learn? And then some notes on the recruiting/hiring manager. So the different inline database views you have are all of the applications, which like I showed earlier, is sorted in the way that it was. Then there's interested, which is these. Then you have current, which is everything that's basically not interested or not rejected, or also you could have stages not offered and stages not signed. It's basically any of the yellow ones. You just want to have it be any of the yellow ones here. And then you can actually see it by the stage in this board view. You can see it by the stage in the board view, which is nice as well. So you can see where we're at on things and see whether you got the jobs, you got rejected from the jobs, whether there's nothing available, where you're at with the multiple different processes. Then we could also look at it by the due date of the application, which is a nice one as well. And if we wanted to, we can also filter things out by job type or job location. If we took a filter here and made it to where the location type is a certain one, whether it's in-person, remote, or hybrid, that would be a good one as well. So for example, if we made a new one called job location, we can have it be filtered by location type is remote. So we can change this one to being called remote jobs. So if you're looking for specifically remote jobs, then you can have that one and not have to worry about getting confused with any of the other ones. And there is obviously different ways that you can set this up and to your own preference. I know that there are different types of applications and different types of job markets. However, I feel like this is a decent baseline for having a setup to at least organize what jobs you're looking at and what jobs you're applying for.
Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I will see you guys in the next one.